Hey folks, Quilly Team here, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play XCOM 2. Just finished a guerrilla ops last time. Ooh, supply convoy with intel. Not now, but we may want it. We actually have a decent amount of intel right now. What I believe we're going to do is finish building the radio relay. In New Chile? Yeah. I mean, we also have to run this mission here, certainly. Although we're not quite at the extreme worry point yet, but it's actually pretty darn close. Oh, we're going to run the mission once we get our beam cannon. So just come down here. We'll be in the right area, regardless, which is going to be nice. We'll go ahead and build that relay. And then I don't think we'll have enough supplies to get the sniper rifle. But with the beam cannon, I think I'll feel very comfortable going after the facility, just popping off that thing.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts.
Sign new research. I mean, we can start the next research, and we will. The plasma lance, which I assume is the next level sniper rifle.
I'll see that work begins immediately.
But we have to wait for that research to finish, and we'll have to have enough money for it. Which, I just realized, I'm talking about money. We're not actually going to have the beam cannon.
Hey, Commander.
I was getting confused between the research and the building. We need 250 supply for that. These are not squad-wide upgrades. None of these are squad-wide upgrades.
Pickings are slim, but I'm hoping we find a few more recruits who can handle a wrench. I could use the help.
We could go with, well, not literally an old colonel mission. We'd be short one colonel in total, and we'd have one shaken one. But we can throw a lot of stuff at this alien facility. Let's take a look at... We'll probably need to go, actually. When's the next supply drop? It would be really nice if we could finish building the relay before the supply drop, though, to get more supplies. I'm going to risk it. It's certainly a bit risky. Ooh, shielded coil room, where we will want to build the power relay. So I guess I'll get started there, because we are going to do it. I'm probably going to go and remove the power relay somewhere else, actually. Yeah, assign at least one worker, and we actually have gremlins down here, too. Oh, could I just put a gremlin? Nice. Okay, good. Keep the engineer free for something else. That would be another build facility over here, which we don't need to do. Alien machinery needs to be cleared, so let's go and get that. We don't have any gremlins over here. So let's get you to excavate over there. Excellent. So yeah, my plan is to remove this power relay, because both of these are on an actual power core. I mean, I needed to build this at the time. But by doing that, I'm going to be able to supply all my power over here. We'll eventually get them updated and all that. Okay. And go.
Signal's coming through clear.
Excellent. Boosting our supply, which is going to be nice for next supply drop. And I think we just go and do this facility now. All right. Heavy mech, elite trooper, gatekeeper, archon, elite shieldbearer, elite lancer, andromedon, and a codex. So to me that says, no hacking apparently, because apparently the gatekeeper can't be hacked. No psi stuff, so we don't have to worry about our own willpower, so we can bring the shaken person. There's going to be a fair amount of armor kicking around, but that's pretty standard all the time. And certainly we want a couple of flashbangs just to make sure we catch the codex, because we actually don't know how many of them there will be. Although, yeah. So, I mean, I guess a relatively standard comp. And what I'll do is I'll remove everyone. As I do. And then I'm going to take... I'm definitely going to take Ultimate Thal. We're going to try to get her to not be shaken. And then high-ranked people who aren't colonels for XP is probably fine. I mean, it's a hard mission, but not the hardest. So, Alivard for our specialist. So, we got Grenadier specialist. We're going to grab Burlo for our sharpshooter. Lots of majors. It's going to be a pretty highly ranked mission. We're going to bring a PsyOps, because bringing a PsyOps all the time is great, even though you don't get experience points. Grenadier specialist, sharpshooter. Oh, we need a ranger. The one we brought last time is wounded. So, I think we'll just bring one of our good rangers. We'll bring 91-bit. That'll be fine. So, Colonel over here. And then we can duplicate one thing. I'm tempted, because I feel... And with the Gatekeeper, we may have to just brute force the armor piercing, so I think we might bring another Grenadier. We'll bring Desti Virago over here, who needs the experience points. We'll make all the armor available, we'll make all the utility items available, and then we'll go and deck them out. This is the Tracer Rounds, yes? Yes. Okay, I'll have the trace around there. On our sharpshooter, I'm going to go and give you the spider armor. And you will get the AP rounds, which is quite good, because you're very reliably able to hit people, and oftentimes I'm like, but you still have armor right now, and we can't shred that. So I'm going to love having the AP rounds, I think, on the sniper. We are going to make sure we've got the flashbangs, so our ranger here, you're going to go flashbang comboed with a mimic beacon. And we've got another flashbang here on our psyops, which just seems to be okay. Alivard, you're going to grab... Oh, I lost another... that's it. I lost the other flash... No, there's the flashbang. I lost the other mimic beacon. So I only have one. That's the other thing I lost. So I lost the EXO armor, and I lost the flashbang, and I lost one of my psyops. All, you know, not really particularly good things. You need to make sure you have the med kit. And I'll give you a skulljack in case we do some sniping magic over there. That's going to be fine. I'm happy with your loadout. We do need a second sight... grenade, most likely. So you get double flashbang, only one mimic. I'll have to build some more. Can I, how expensive are they? I need 75 supplies, so I can't mimic right now. So I guess I can just put the second sight thing over here, and that'll be a pretty good comp. We're using less of our experimental ammo on this go. But not bad. Double flash, double sight, only one mimic. We do have the hack as well. One healer, but we should have plenty of health kits. Alright, let's do it. Perfectly fine. I'll catch you guys on the flip side of the loading screen. Okay, and here we are in our facility mission. We've got to blow something up over here with the X4 charges. And I always look at that as a time 4 charges, but no, we only have to plant one. We are concealed, which is good, and no time limit. I'm going to get started with, there we go, 91-bit over here. And I'm going to start off with a single move here. Obviously, I'm not moving into cover, but that's going to be fine. I just want to see if there's any enemies that... Ew. Can we just ignore this? We can just go around it, right? Now, I mean, if this was a moving patrol, I wouldn't want to do that because they might move and join in some other fight afterwards. But it's a static roadblock, which means if we go around it and we initiate our fights outside of its vision range, there's absolutely no way that we'll have to deal with it. Now, it's a very easy thing for us to kill, and certainly we can get more experience points by killing it as well, and maybe a drop, but it would cause us to lose concealment. If we were really concerned about... you know, maximizing all of our XP and our drop potential, I could come back at the end of the mission and kill it. But right now, staying in concealment is much, much more valuable, so that's what we're going to do. I'll just go around it. Yeah, I like that. I don't strictly have to... Since there's no one around, like, and we definitely, there's no one that's going to patrol that far, I don't think I actually need to end my turns here in concealment. So, I'm going to be okay with that. And I'll just try to keep the squad together and moving as a group as much as possible. I mean, I don't want to advance any further out of concealment.
Location but confirmed.
In line with our current characters, that was going to be okay. Move you there. We still got sight grenades and dropping a sight grenade. Or battle scanner, I should say. Oh, there we go. This would actually drop me in cover. So that's perfectly fine to do. It's my last character. Not good to move too far forward with your last character, but we're still concealed, so it's fine. Okay, all good. Alivard, that is not concealment. Hang on. Is there someone else I can move that can move to a convenient concealed spot? Yeah, right over here. Desti Virago. You can move up. So we're trying to get far enough away from this so it's not going to have its sight. Do I want to double move up to here? Yeah, sure. Actually, maybe I'll go more like here.
On my way.
Which should maximize our vision radius a little bit.
We've got a hostile squad here.
Indeed we do. Now, they're all facing away from me, which makes me think they're going to be patrolling away, which is a bit annoying. We might, in theory, be able to bypass them by going in over here. But because, like, people can move, and we don't want them sneaking up on us and joining a fight in process. So we will plan on ambushing these guys. We've got all the time in the world. We can wait for them to patrol back to us. That's going to be okay. Totally fine. Right? Yeah, probably. Mm-hmm. That seems reasonable. 91-bit. Since your concealment's not going to be broken when the rest of the squad engages, why don't you go and, yeah, make a move this way. We're not going to move through any things. Nope.
Okay.
We can move over here. We're going to keep using you to clear things up. If I do want 91-bit to engage in the fight that we're about to do, I will have to move her back over this way. So far, so good. And we can also drop a sight beacon over there. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move 91-bit a little bit closer this way. Because if I do want her to fight, I need to make sure she doesn't get spotted by anything weird. Ultimate Thal. You cannot move into particularly good cover. Oh, I should have left that spot for you. Poop. And no one else has got an action, right? Oh, Burlo does, but... Yeah, Burlo could move up to here. Which is fine. I mean, Burlo's a sniper. You don't usually want the sniper at the front, but... Although, for pistol stuff... And that is a perfectly fine location. I could also go here. Which... I will do. I'm happy with that. Still means that... Who is it? Desti? Or Ultimate Thal? I mean, I guess I can move you here to some sort of partial cover. I think I'm gonna have to hang you back over here. I don't think, when these guys patrol back, actually, they shouldn't move close enough to get in a radius. And even if they do, they shouldn't actually count as a true flank. So it shouldn't pop concealment. And I think they're moving away from us anyway. And the fact that we're not getting a movement animation for them, for me, confirms that. There's a lot of people moving around. That's a long walking turn. Who's got a sight bomb for us? Dead meat. Now, I don't necessarily care about that. It's more like over here. Should I just put it on the roof? I might have good vision. So this area is clear, so I'm going to put it on the roof like... Oh, right there. I like that. Because it should give us... Alright, there we go. So it should give us pretty good cover of things. Coverage of things. We've got an Andromedon thing or whatever, and a Codex parked out there. We got a target over there. Nothing that we can see inside there yet. I could keep the current position. I could just drop more vision things. But, someone else has got vision. There we go. And I'd rather drop, like, one on each. That way I still have two people who have vision options. So let's drop this one maybe inside the building. It would be nice if... Because I don't know if there's anything on the other side of the door. Oh, but... But with the door there... So I guess we can get vision if I pop it through this window. Is there another window over here? Not one I could reach. There are some back here. So if I drop it... Oh, I like... Hold on. I'm getting it. That, I think, is upstairs. It's hard to tell. This looks like it's indoors. So I'm going to do that. There we go. Okay. Well, no one just on the other side of the door, which makes me very confident. Okay, we don't want to fight this other squad while we fight the first one. I do have all the time in the world. Wow, you can actually still hit the turret from here. I do have all the time in the world, so I might just sit here. We could advance a little bit. We'd have to be worried about potentially getting popped by a flank. That's relatively safe, though. Actually, you know what I would like? I'm going to move Ultimate Thal to right there.
Moving out.
And then I want to move 91-bit out of there. Here should be okay. I think it's very unlikely that we'll get flanked by that other patrol. And I think we're just going to sit here and wait.
Eyes on the prize.
There, this would be the one time I would very much like the Overwatch All mod. Normally, I don't care about it because I'm very likely to click something that I don't want. I mean, the Overwatches aren't going to trigger because they're not going to trigger their sight right now. They're not going to spot me, so the Overwatches aren't going to go. It was just something to hit. I guess I could hit the end turn button. Okay, well, I can't start a fight now. Well, technically, hold on. Since we literally don't see them, right? There's fog of war. That means they literally won't see us either. I think we actually could start this round. What would be really nice is if we could start with a null lance. Which I think... Okay, ooh. Null Lance hurts our own people, right? Yeah. And it's also got a bit of range. So, I think what I'm going to do is move Dead Meat to here. And then we'll have to see if we have vision over the other group or not. We're still concealed right now, so this is a fine move. Are you within range of that other group? You are. Okay. So we can't engage now, because that will trigger the other group to come in, which is really unfortunate. I think we just sit tight some more, because again, this shouldn't result in any flank. Unless this group literally walks to, like, right here, and therefore gets a flank on dead meat, this will not break our concealment. So I'm just gonna just be patient.
Scan them cool. Got it covered. On Overwatch. Moving to Overwatch. Vigilance.
I guess I could have just, again, hit and turn. But I feel a little safer with the Overwatch, just in case for some reason they spot us. They are getting awfully close. Stop. 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 Okay, we're fine. The bigger question is, what's the other group doing? I think we can only see them because of the sight grenade that's over there, the battle scanner. There's no way. I mean, if I look here and I tab between people, no one's got the little targeting. Well, we do there. But yeah, no, there's no way that other group sees us. We only see them because of the battle scanner. So I think we can very safely engage here. And I think the way to start will indeed be the Null Lance, which cannot miss. Does 7 to 12 damage, which means... Oh, no, I can't hit them all. There's a good chance we'll hit both people in the back as well. And other than that, do we just do a bunch of overwatching? I mean, I could start with something else. Because it would be nice if the Overwatch is triggered in the correct order so that we shred this guy's armor first. But I think we're just going to be able to wipe the whole group in one go. I don't think we need a Mimic Beacon. 91-bit does not Overwatch because she's not going to break concealment. But everyone else will. And that's why I don't have that mod, because I don't want to Overwatch everyone except one person. There's actually two people I don't want to Overwatch. We also have the... Oh, that's Skull Mine, right? I don't have the AoE. So no, just conceal. Dead Meat, no. 91-bit, no. Desti, yes.
I'm on it.
Dead Meat, no. 91-bit, no. Burlo. Do I want to Overwatch? I am tempted to almost do a pistol Overwatch here, just because... What's my two-hit chance? Okay, wait. Hold on. Oh! The Codex will trigger! But I can't wait any longer. I mean, come on. I really can't. They might turn around and patrol the other way, but if they don't... Actually, if they don't, and they do pop my concealment this turn, they will pop it on their action. Oh, this is... Yeah, they'll pop it on their action, which means none of them will actually shoot. Meanwhile, my entire squad will be overwatching. That's... Okay, we're going to wait one more turn then, since...
Affirmative. Covering now. Tout de suite.
Yeah, okay, so they did spot. So if I had gone and attacked on my turn, I would have been able to start with the Null Lance, which would have been awesome. But it would have meant that the Codex would be able to actually attack on its turn. And now, there's even the chance that the Codex moved away first and will not have a vision radius. Okay, that's a pretty damn good start. Are we... Did we not... We didn't get an overwatch on this guy because he didn't run to cover. He doesn't feel the need to run to cover. Bonus, though, the Codex did move away first. So that actually worked out really, really, really well. Since we have infinite amount of time right here, let's see if we can mind control this guy. Because if we fail to mind control him, he will die this turn. Regardless. So, control enemy. 49% chance. I mean, if we fail... They would get an increased defense stat, but I think this thing still dies in one turn. So temporary control, I don't know how long it lasts. I think it's somewhere around 3-ish turns or something like that. And we don't get to move it this turn. But alright. So 91-bit, you're still concealed. So why don't you go ahead and first move up
to
here.
Moving to designated position.
Alright, finish your move up to here then. You'll still be concealed. Alright, we really don't have any vision whatsoever. Still feeling okay. Yeah, I guess if 91-bit can't see anyone... And that's clearly the case. That should mean everyone else can move up safely, right? Even into a double move? This is all a solid wall. We know there was no one on the other side. I could go here. Or here would be fine. This is a solid wall. No one from inside can see us. I'm mostly concerned about ways that the Codex might patrol back, but as long as it doesn't trigger on our turn... I wouldn't want to move here. I mean, I would love to move here, but... Alright, let's drop a new battle scanner. I'm going to feel safer doing this. There's another group in there. Okay, and that's where the Codex Andromedon moved. So, okay, this is clearly, like, well out of range of all the things, right? I don't see any little targeting thing. Nowhere around here, so this should be 100% not getting spotted.
On it.
Much and dead meat. You'll just scooch up a little bit, because you threw a grenade, so that used one of your actions. Okay. And Dusty Virago, the question is, what do I do with you? And I think the answer will just be move to here.
Stepping off.
Which should be completely fine. Burlo, my little sniper. It'd be nice if we could get you up on the roof, because apparently there's, like, nothing up there. I'm going to try a single move. It'll be interesting to see if we can grapple after that, but I suspect we'll be too far away. Grapple is enabled. And we can do it. Do I feel completely confident that there's nothing up there? Not completely. There could be... No, there's not really... There's just a little landing there. There's not really a floor on that side. Where is there? I guess there is. There could be some group there. We don't have another sight beacon. Yeah, I'm not excited enough to be up there to risk that move. I think I will just move to here, which is, should be perfectly safe. And that will end our round. Watch this trigger an enemy group. That would be brutal. You are still hacked. I don't know if it's a duration or if there's like a percentage chance every turn. Maybe that's how it works. Oh, you moved away. Oh, that's so annoying. I would love to just attack you and no one else. You know what we're going to do? We're just going to blow up the mech. That's what we're going to do. Hack mechs are cool and all, but you know what's not cool? Mechs that stop being hacked. So, Dusty Virago... This thing can't hit back, so it's going to be perfect. It's like it's stunned for longer, because... Alright. Seriously? Seriously?
Missed.
Seriously? And no one else has got armor shred. So... Scooch up to here, because okay. We still want you scooching generally up. That's going to be fine. You'll be in a bad position if the mech wakes up, but... Otherwise... We don't have... I'm not crazy, right? I don't have another... Another heavy? Oh yeah, I do. Ultimate Thull over here. Derp derp. 99% chance. Oh, we do have the hull of targeting, which helped trigger there too, so. There we go. Shred a little bit of the armor. And everyone's just gonna sit where you are, and you're gonna kill the defenseless robot.
Son armure quel coup.
We can use some more bullets. We might want to go into a reload thing, but we're mostly okay. You're still concealed. Actually, and you will still be concealed if we say move to here. Or maybe even here. It's not full concealment. I'm not sure what kind of vision we're going to have from this location. Oh, you know what you can do? You can establish that the roof is safe. Yeah, I'm going to get you to single move up to here. Excellent. And over here. Roof is absolutely clear. Burlo. Well, that might lead to vision. But otherwise, the roof is good. Oh, yeah. We moved up to here and we didn't have vision. Well, they moved far enough away, or did they? Because it would be great to just end on the corner. But of course, that might get us into a bunch of trouble. So I'm just going to move up to here so that you're on the roof. And perhaps here, you actually have some line of sight to things. Oh, great cover there. But this is the last action of the round, so I can't have any of that happen. So just move up to here. No, 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 come on! Really? And that's our last action. Really? How? This was fine, this one was not. Aw, come on, game. This was a clear location, we confirmed, because we didn't have line of sight with anything with 91-bit from here. But here, there's line of sight to the death thing. I mean, it could be worse. Oh, this actually counts as us being flanked as well? Yeah, it does, doesn't it? I guess we'll move to here. It does put two of us together, which might open us up to some grenades. I guess I can move to here. That might be fine. I'm going to trigger my running gun.
En position de tir.
Which I think will still just give me one action.
Ouais, j'y vais.
But it does open up the possibility. Ooh. It would be nice to kill the shield bearer before he gets to shield everyone, but I don't think that can happen with pistols. So I think what I'm going to do is go for the 93% chance lightning hands here. Oh! That's good. And I was going to say pistol, but rather than pistol, why don't I just face off? Actually, no. That's silly. I'll just keep my face off cooldown, because everyone else has got too much armor for the face off to do much. So yeah, I'll save the cooldown. If we hit, and we don't roll minimum damage... Okay, decent start. I'm still really unhappy about triggering this group. Really unhappy. But it could be worse. Now the Codex is going to trigger from other crap. That'll be really bad. If this guy blows me up with some sort of AoE and knocks me down through the floor...
J'ajuste ma visée.
Then that might be really bad because it might generate the other group. So you're doing your shielding. Hope that doesn't shield the guys who we can't see yet. If the Codexes show up with like 5 extra armor, I may be a bit disappointed. Let me come back to you, Alvard. You probably will need to do some healing. The problem is the rest of my group isn't in a situation where they can do anything. Well, 91-bit could run down here and open the door, which will give us line of sight. I think that's exactly what I have to do. I have to get line of sight on this monster. Do I want to flashbang it? No, but I will probably drop a mimic beacon.
Moving on target location.
I don't know if dropping the mimic beacon will pop my concealment or not. I don't know, but we are definitely going to mimic. Right there. Guarantee for sure that the orb here, what is it called, the gatekeeper? Oh yeah, it does pop me. Guarantees that the gatekeeper will fire at that thing. The shield bearer, since he doesn't have line of sight, may not. I don't think we need to flashbang at this point. I'm very worried about moving here and triggering the other group, though. God. Okay, ultimate thaw, if you go here, you will get the line of sight on the gatekeeper. Okay, we're going to do that, and we're going to try to go for a shred.
What's over there?
What's our chance to hit on the thread? On the shred. Or rupture, I should say. 67% is pretty poor. Now, ideally, I would like the rupture to go first because it's plus 3 damage for everyone else. But, Dusty Virago, you have hollow targeting. So if you, in fact, go first, you'll give everyone else, whether you hit or miss, everyone else will get plus 15, which is pretty strong. Oh, and you can hail a bullet. So you guarantee a hit, which will shred some armor. And then give plus 15 to hit with our Ravage guy. It means we won't get to take advantage of the bonus Rupture damage, but it'll increase the odds that the Rupture lands, which I think is more important.
Hard target, minimal damage.
Okay, so now we go here, and Rupture, 83%. I mean, I could go for more guaranteed damage and more armor shred, but I think I like the Rupture. It did hit. Thank goodness. And critted. Wow, crazy.
That armor's tough.
Yeah, the armor is tough, but we're actually okay. In fact, to the point where I'm even considering facing off. But no, I think instead we'll fire. Although, hold on. Burlo, you have... I forgot about that. You have the armor-piercing rounds. But a face-off won't kill him, whereas if I hit with a snipe, it actually will finish this guy off. Either way, we ignore armor, I suppose, so some of the order didn't matter. But the plus 3 damage does, and the plus 15 holocarding helps. Beautiful! I forgot you exploded, but that's okay. And death from above. You still ignore armor. I don't know if you ignore shielding. What else would you possibly do? I suppose you could reload, you could overwatch. It's only 48% chance. You know what? Take the pistol shot. It's fine. All right, we missed. That's all right. He still has full cover. I'm still really worried about triggering the other group accidentally. Well, not accidentally anymore. This trigger was accidental, although it turned out to be okay. There's not really any way for me to get line of sight on that dude, regardless. So, this is safe. I mean, this, I don't think, would potentially open up any kind of line of sight issues. So, I think I'm just going to move to here and then Overwatch. Or, oh, Inspire! Who's got line of sight on the enemy? Just the dude on the roof. Well, you would, but you don't have any ammo. Suppose you could grenade him. It's only one action. Let's move Alivard up. You guys haven't actually... Oh, you did take a bunch of damage. That's right. So we're going to go and Gremlin heal Burlow. And actually, I should have hunkered down. And in fact, maybe I will do that. That's what I should have used her action for. So I don't like the fact that I'm going to use a really powerful cooldown right now. I am totally safe to move here, right?
On the move.
I'll move there. I will go... Yeah, I shouldn't have done it this way. But I will inspire Burlow simply to do a hunker down. You're going to be full covered and hunkered down, and hopefully that means no one is going to shoot at you. Or they can shoot at you and just hopefully miss. Now, if the Codex group... What's it pointing at? Oh, it's shooting over here. Wait, what's shooting? What? What's shooting with 100% chance to hit? Oh, you're shooting at the Mimic Beacon. But the question remains, what is shooting at you with 100% chance to hit? I forgot I had a Mimic Beacon down. I'm still not ashamed about having done the hunker, but I forgot about the Mimic Beacon, and I am ashamed of that. Mm-hmm. Why don't we... I would like to get Dead Meat up here, so that I can get a 0%... Oh, I can hit you from here? Oh, well, that'll solve that. This might... Okay, I'm going to take the risk. In theory, the Codex group could... No, we're good. So we're going to use Soulfire, which can't miss and ignores all the defensive stuff. Although, I wonder if I just, like, stasis you or something like that to reset your shielding. Oh, there we go. We got the insta-kill. We rolled max damage, which is what we needed. Just ignore all the things. Great stuff. We're not on a time limit. I don't want to trigger the other group. I think everyone is literally going to sit where they are, reload. We'll do a bit of overwatching just in case the other group comes by. We might be able to get a free shot, but we are going to be sitting on our hands.
Got it covered.
Reload. I mean, you know, some people can move up a little bit if there's no risk of triggering anything, but nope, I like it. If anyone was going to do it, it might be 91-bit, but he's also the one, or she's also the one that would get into the most possible trouble, so that's no good. So just reload and overwatch where you are. I mean, if the Codex group does move forward, there's a good chance that a lot of us won't be able to fire. Plus, there's a problem that the Codex group will probably do a bunch of cloning if we do get any Overwatch off, but I don't know, it's fine. I didn't see that coming. At all. At all. This is unfortunate. Guardian. Okay, that's a lot of missing. We should have easily actually killed the Archon in one go. Another miss? Oh wait, how many people are coming around here? How many times are we triggering Overwatch? Another miss? Come on!
Adjusting aim.
Oh my god, and there's another Death Orb. What the hell? Okay, well, we definitely have to make sure we don't accidentally trigger the freaking Codex group here. What the shitballs? Is there any way I can line up and get a good Null Lance? I mean, maybe literally if I go here and aim sort of upwards, that might happen. Holy crap! Alright, I think the right thing to do is going to be to try to shred some armor off this dude. And I'm going to do that with Hail of Bullets. 100% chance. We'll get that going. We don't have holotargeting in this guy, do we? No, right, we have the volatile mix and all those things. Which is pretty good. And actually, hold on. Is there a way? I can't tell with the trees in the way. Where's the other Archon? Yeah, he's up there. I don't know if that's hitting the guy inside. Oh no, it's not. Okay, this, and then it wouldn't hit the Archons. Potentially if I move around. And I do have more than one of these dudes. Well, I guess, okay, let's move to here. It's a great location. Now you don't have, yeah, volatile mix and all those things. Okay.
Is it clear?
Oh, for crying out loud. That turret we've been ignoring the entire game. but we will actually have good cover from that. So hopefully it's going to be okay. There we go. So I can drop a grenade here. We'll hit all three. I don't know if Archons can fall down. There might be falling damage. It'll also shred some armor. Can't miss. Alright, I mean, only one armor shred. We got a crit over there, though. Right, you'll do your battle berserk thing, blah, blah, blah. Let me come back to you, Alivard. It's actually Ultimate Thal I want to take next. I think if I moved Ultimate Thal here, I believe I would be able to get another really good grenade on all three. And I think that's the thing to do. Shred aside, I think that's going to be the pro move. So let me do that. I wonder, now that some of the wall's busted, actually, we might be able to get a shot from where we are. And indeed we are. There we go. That's literally the same tile as last time, I think. So I'm going to do that. So this isn't going to be the maximum amount of armor shred, but it is a hell of a lot of damage. A hell of a lot of damage. Okay, one Archon down. And we would very much like to finish off the other Archon before we do anything else. So the question is, simply, how are we going to finish off the Archon? ...95% chance. You don't have a hit on anything else. I suppose we could also pistol, but... there's a chance we'd roll too low to actually kill it. So, yeah, I think we just snipe the Archon from here. Excellent. We even critted. Just to show off. And that's death from above. I'm actually running away here. Because what if the other group comes? What if this thing floats up to us? What if? I could pistol Overwatch, though. And you know what? I think I'm going to be fine with just pistol Overwatch. Dead meat? Oh, you can't get a shot there. Really? And I'm not sure flashbanging is going to make a difference. Although, it does affect their hit chance. Okay, you have a shot from here. So what we could do is actually move 91 bit first. If I move to here, I'll have full cover. You also have a flashbang.
I'm trusting you here.
What's, oh, right there, explosives. I don't think I want to use the explosive, actually. I think what I want to do is shoot at this guy. Yeah, I think that's going to be fine. Crit, 9 damage, very nice.
Armor's still holding.
Which means...
Move
over
position.
Here. Who else is left, actually? Deadmeat and Alivard as well. I could stasis this thing, but I can null lance, which does ignore the defenses and has a minimum damage of 7, which is exactly what we need.
Where will you run?
Brump. Okay.
Possible intel located.
Oh, that's nice. We have to make sure not to trigger the other group, though. And also, it would be nice if I didn't move anyone else in range of the turret. Which here would not be, although there's some amount of fire going on. I don't think we need to heal anyone. You're mostly full, Burlo. Suppose I could double move to here, but I don't want to accidentally trigger another group here. So maybe I'll just move up to here for now. Not very close to the fire, not particularly at risk. Oh, that might be a good way to take care of the turret. I forgot about doing a hairwire protocol. Let's do that. I'll probably go for a hack. The only target's got has full cover. If I can just hack it. Now, you know what? Let's just stun it, because we're going to move away from the turret. That guarantees it cannot fire at us. Boom, done. Plus, failing would increase its aim, which would be not preferable. That would be really bad, actually. So there we go. Just stun that guy. Perfect. And that's the end of the turn, right? You're stunned. Good. Super heavy turret. Yeah, it's got a lot of hit points, actually. The armor didn't scale up that much. Okay, a little bit of stuff on fire. Can anyone move in such a way to pick that up and still have an action? If I do a running gun, then yeah. So I'm going to start by doing this move.
If you say so.
Lyrium core, superior autoloader, alien data cache, and another superior autoloader. Oh, not bad.
Where to?
Oh, there's another turret on that roof. It's vaguely annoying. I can break line of sight pretty easily, though. Yeah, just by doing this, it won't have line of sight anymore. And that's generally what I want to do. What I want to do is, I'm going to run and gun.
Running and gunning.
Move there. Actually, I guess I could have moved a little further away. And I don't want to end my action, though. So I'm wondering if more of these things will actually result in the turret seeing me. But let's do this. We have to make moves forward at some point. We're actually in a pretty good state right now. Still don't know where that other dude is. Alright, I probably should have kept my ranger where we were and just made these attacks. And what I will do is be very cautious about my continued forward movement to avoid overextending for that Codex group. But I do have to finish this turn. How's my sniper? You can hit the turret. Oh, that's that turret, which is currently stunned, but won't be stunned forever. You know what? It's okay, go for it. Oh, you have armor-piercing rounds. No crit, but that's fine. Dusty Virago. Yeah, just go and finish it off. Since we're not moving forward, we'll play it safe. We'll finish this one off. And get, you know, bonus XP. You didn't die? Oh, shit. I'm saying we'll get bonus XP and stuff. It'll be great. You just overwatch because the Codex group might move forward. This is a safe location. Do you actually get a shot on the turret up top? The turret up top die? I didn't think I killed it. Anyway, this can't possibly trigger anything new. So do that. And probably you'll just be on overwatch. That's a lot of people next to a car that could explode, which makes me a bit uneasy. That's all right. I'll move here. Might be slightly better angles of attack. All right, just overwatch. Overwatch. I don't know where that Codex group is. What is it? Codex plus Andromedon? Ugh. Oh, well, they're moving around over there. That's where they are. Okay, so they spot us on their turn, though, which is good. They won't be able to attack. We might get some overwatches off. Ideally, it'd be nice if the overwatches... I guess we don't have any armor threat. Say, it'd be nice if the armor watches all went off after this guy, and it is. Did we... I hope we didn't just hit the car, which is now going to explode. Good shots. We actually get through its armor round first. We would like very much to flashbang the Codex, which should be fine. We'd also like to kill this. It's got no armor anymore. It's in the second phase, so 14 unarmored hit points is pretty dealable with. You're going to take a shot over there. Just don't hit. Oh my god. 20% chance to hit. I mean, of course, that will hit one in every five times, but... Alright, missed. You're going to be poisoning people just by virtue... Okay, the car is... I don't think it's on fire. There's some sparking lights here, which has me a bit concerned. And I think we've established that we can safely just pop this big guy without any explosions. However, we need to make sure we flashbang the Codex. So I think my priority here... Oh, I mean, I could stasis as well. Who else has got the flashbang? 91 bit. I guess I'll move you to here.
I guess that'll be okay.
And I'm going to try to flashbang the codex with you. There. That will cover her.
Take a good look.
Technically, I'm being flanked by the big guy, but the big guy melees, so it's moot. Can't soul fire. Really, neither one of the two things can be soul fired. Interesting. But we can inspire, and I might save for that. Alvard, you're going to reload. And just take the shot. 100% chance to hit. I may want to see if I can feed someone experience points. Well, it doesn't have to be dead meat. We know that for sure. Ultimate Thull is already full of XP. Destiny Virago could use some more XP, though. I'm going to ignore the turret, because if I literally just move over here, then the turret is not an issue. It'd be nice to come back and kill it later for more potential stuff, but... Alright, we're going to finish you off this way. Actually, knock you off the thing.
You happy now?
Promotion earned. Nice. Let's see here. Burlo. Oh, Burlo's got a shot. Excellent. And actually, you can Lightning Hands. This thing is... Yeah, it is, what is it? Disoriented, so it's not going to split. Oh, 8-point crit, nice! Burlo also does not have max XP, so getting a kill on you would also be very good. Boom! Oh, exactly 4. It was Gray's shot, but it's what we needed. Death from above gives you another action, but there's nothing really to do. I could reload, which is probably a great idea. Let's just go ahead and do that. Ultimate Thull. As I say, can we move in such a way that doesn't get you poisoned? I'm pretty sure that's it. I'm pretty sure that's all until more people decide to drop in, which they might do at this point. I think they will do once we plant the explosives.
Menace 1-5, you're near the target position.
It'd be nice if you did not run through poison. There's not a whole lot of... Oh, that's it, huh? Alright, just reload. And why don't you move over to here and we'll get you a reload as well.
Locked and loaded.
I mean, I don't think there's anything left around. God, that would be really bad if I did this and all of a sudden something triggered. Oh! The salt would flow. Okay, I expected that. I expected there, once we finished off that group, to be reinforcements. They're often a little bit squishier, but we definitely have a little bit left to do. I probably want to set up for a full ambush over there, which is what I'm going to do here. I'm going to leave my position here. I don't have cover, but that's okay. It's going to reload, and then overwatch with Destiny Virago. Oh,
yeah. Overwatch.
And Alvard can move out here too. Again, not much in the way of cover. I guess I can probably shoot him from here.
Ça devrait pouvoir se faire.
91 bits. I don't know if he'll have line of sight. But we'll give it a go.
So.
You're not going to be able to reload, unfortunately, but...
Come get some.
Dead meat will boole you right back to there.
Got it covered.
It's possible this would be quite a long-distance shot, but it might work.
All right, I'll go.
And at least we'll be close enough that next round we'll be able to do something. Oh! Oh, we're back at the turret! Okay. It's just really weird. Oh my god. And we have no cover from the turret. And you have no shot over here either. Well, you're just gonna have to overwatch for the dropping people. Yeah, I'm really worried Ultimate Thull is gonna take a crap ton of damage from that turret. Can't believe! That was like one tile there! Well, we should be able to destroy these guys. They did bring... Is that an actual mech? Yeah, it's an actual mech. Two actual mechs! That is the most brutal drop I've seen to date. That is really bad. And the battle mechs, I was going to say, may not move, which means we don't get to trigger overwatch against them. In fact, they're going to overwatch against us, which is frustrating. Oh, but apparently we're going to need all of our overwatches to try to kill just one guy. Oh my god! That one was 82% at that. And another miss? Are you effing kidding me? And then that stupid turret.
The armor took care of it.
All right, well, that could have been a hell of a lot worse damage. Oh, you panicked. Fucking amazing. Because that's Ultimate Thal. That's the one with no willpower. And you're going to miss again. And someone's on fire. You know what? We're going to put a cut in here, you guys. This went from going amazingly to going amazingly crap. Just like that. In a sense, I guess it may have been my fault for not finishing off that turret, because that is going to screw us up a little bit, unfortunately. But the rest of this, those missed overwatches, we had a great ambush set up. We have to make sure not to move. Ugh, this is going to suck. Thanks for watching, though, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.